Let's take a look at creating an even cosmetic finish on the carbon fiber Sword of Perseus, and also we're going to be designing a custom wall mount. We left off with the sword fully assembled, but some of the pieces had variations in the finish, and also the edges where the parts were joined together didn't have the same sheen as the rest of the parts. So the first step was to start sanding down the finish somewhat to prepare it for additional coats of epoxy. So I used a flat surface to sand all of the edges and all of the detail areas. The key is to not sand so deep that you go into the carbon fiber. We just want to remove some of the epoxy so we can reveal the low areas and correct those. As usual, sanding, of course, is a lengthy process, so it just takes some patience here. There are definitely some areas that need a little bit more repair than others, where they didn't quite meet against the edges of the mold, where we had some harsh angles. And then also those edges where they meet need the most attention, just to ensure that they're as smooth as possible. I always like to have a brush handy to remove the dust and clean out the sandpaper. It makes it last longer. Also, you do want to make sure that the epoxy is fully cured, because if it's still somewhat tacky, then it's really going to gum up the paper and you're not going to get a good finish. Just keeping an eye to make sure that what's coming off is staying white, because that means I'm just in the epoxy. You start sanding and the dust is turning black, then you are getting into the carbon fiber. You want to stop right away. Of course, that doesn't apply when I'm sanding on these edges, because I do have carbon fiber that's running perpendicular to the parts versus the outside surface. So there's going to be some dark carbon fiber dust coming from those edges and from the edges of the blade. So I continued the sanding process until the whole thing was as smoothed out as possible. I believe I went up to about 400 grit here. And now I'm adding an additional layer of epoxy. And I'd had to complete this process a few times, obviously, and I had to do some additional repair work on the deepest uneven parts. And I used a brush sometimes. Sometimes I just spread it out using gloves or a flat surface. It didn't seem to make a whole lot of difference with regards to how many air bubbles were introduced. The main thing is just to not put it on too thick, because it just drips off anyways. And I kept an eye on the parts as they were curing so that I could correct any drips as they happen, just clean it up as much as possible and reduce the amount of sanding that was going to need to be done after that coat. I set up a wire hook that could suspend the handle so that any drips would head down towards the tip of the sword and just drip off, so that wasn't too bad. Not too much cleanup on that, and just primarily just building up those layers with multiple coats of the epoxy. Some areas were really not bad at all, because they were against the mold, but because I was joining different parts and because I was doing so much experimentation with these parts as I was creating them, there are some areas, as I said, that needed more attention. The downside of these brushes is they tend to leave bristles, so you just have to keep an eye and pull out those bristles anytime you see them. So after more epoxy, then it's more sanding. Did that several times. And now, instead of polishing this at this point, I am going to add a sealer. So I'm just using some lacquer. This is a gloss lacquer, so I removed all of the dust. And I'm adding several light coats This dries very fast, so it's convenient for building up multiple layers. You just want to make sure that obviously there are no drips by trying to go too heavy in one coat. I sprayed the handle section and allowed that to dry so that I then had something to handle the sword by. I could just go ahead and grab onto the handle and spray the second half of the sword that way. So it's already looking much more even now. Still has several coats to go. But the goal is to make it all the same finish, regardless of whether that's a matte finish or a gloss finish, it just needs to be even. I'm gonna go for more of a gloss finish on this though. So while that's drying, I'm gonna go ahead and create the custom hanging bracket. I sketched out a shape that looked good with the sword, and then brought that into Fusion 360 and extruded the parts. I'm doing it in multiple pieces so that I can print the hanging portions that protrude from the back plate. I'm going to print those using a rubberized filament so that it will grip better and not scratch the piece. So I printed out both of those parts, and I also added some pegs on the back so that I can add a hanging wire. So I have a piece of picture wire that I'm going to wrap around those pegs. This wire is kind of overkill considering how light the sword is, but this is what I had on hand, so we're gonna make it work. Wearing gloves at this point really was not entirely necessary, but I'm gonna be using some toxic glue in a moment, so I was ready for that. Probably would have been easier to finagle the wire if I hadn't been wearing gloves though. I just wrapped it around and twisted it around itself so that it wouldn't pop off, but there's really not going to be a whole lot of weight on this since the sword is very light, so this isn't a particularly vital portion here. Probably could have just hung by a nail at the top point there, but I just don't think it's as secure as having a wire that goes through a hook. I don't want this to fall down. So I just integrated the hanging bracket with this to avoid any possible wobbliness or something. All right, hanging bracket's good to go. That's gonna be plenty sturdy for hanging the sword. So we need to go ahead and mount these peg pieces. They're from TPU and the other piece is from an HDPLA. So I have some contact cement I'm going to use on these because super glue isn't going to work as well for the TPU. I typically use contact cement for that. And this particular tube is kind of drying up somewhat, so it's a bit of a challenge to get it out. It's also this really bright yellow, which isn't ideal, so I'll have to take care of that later. Main thing is just I don't want to get it too far into the edge there and have it show through from the front. As long as it's only on the back, it's no big deal. And that needs to be spread onto both surfaces. I'm gonna let it dry a little bit and then stick those together. I'm trying to get out some of the lumps though from this getting all lumpy with it being so old. I did try to be as neat as possible with this, but it was not the easiest thing to apply with it being so stringy. So we'll have to fix that later. Even though it's on the bag, it still bothers me. Printing this in separate parts was the easiest way to get a nice finish on the front and also have the pegs print well without having to use any support. So that was another advantage of printing this in three parts instead of trying to do it all in one. Otherwise, I would have needed to have a whole bunch of support structures at the back. That would just waste filament and be a pain to remove, so this was the cleanest way to do that. And that front surface of the plate that was down on my print bed, It came out with some irregularities just from some surface imperfections on the print bite surface. So I just polished that. I used some fine grit sandpaper and polishing compound, and that brought it back to a nice, even finish on that. And the pegs I'm just going to leave as they are. They're great with TPU, so they're strong and they're not going to cause any scratches. The fit here wasn't quite as tight as I'd hoped for. It was a good fit, but not a snug fit, so the glue was definitely important for ensuring that these didn't start to poke out the back. So I pressed those in and pressed the glue together, and that just needs to dry for a while now. I did add some more glue at the back there to reinforce the edges, try and make sure that it's going to be nice and secure. The more I tried to reinforce it, the messier it got. So at some point I had to just stop. It doesn't need to be extremely strong because the sword is so light, but definitely don't want these shifting around. So just a nice kind of caulking edge there. So it's going to make sure that it's locked in place. And once that was dry, it was really messy looking. So I just used some paint to take down that bright yellow so that it looks neat on the back as well as the front. With this filament, there was just no need to paint the whole thing. It comes out with a nice finish if you polish it up. So while that paint is drying, let's check out the sword. It's all dry now and it's been polished after the sealer. So everything's turned out well with that, and it does fit with the hanging bracket nicely. All of the finish imperfections have been cleaned up, so it's nice and even. So let's go ahead and test this out on a wall. So just mount it with a simple picture hanging wire or picture hanging bracket, and that hangs nice and straight. Everything's looking good. I wouldn't say that it's sharp, but you could certainly cause some damage with it. Quite happy with how this turned out. It was an interesting experiment that in this case worked. They don't always work, but this one turned out quite well.